Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Riley.
And I'm Courtney.
And we built a 30 by 40 pole barn here in North Idaho on 20 acres that's fully off-grid.
We had a problem to solve because we wanted to be off-grid, but we have a lot of tools.
So we do a lot of welding, fabricating, woodworking, and all of those tools require a way to power them.
And that's where Current Connected came in.
Current Connected stepped up. They engineered us an amazing residential-style power system that's going to be able to power our entire property and anything we're ever doing here.
We are so excited because we have been listening to a generator for the last year, and I don't think we're going to have to fire that thing up ever again.
So if you've been thinking about taking the plunge and upgrading the power system at your place, I'd highly recommend you give Current Connected a call. They do not only off-grid, but on-grid systems as well. They sell all the components, including batteries, inverters, and everything in between.
So thank you so much to Current Connected for supporting the channel and helping us out.
So we went ahead and assembled some of the best parts we could find. And in today's video, I'll make sure I cover every little detail about the system that powers their dreams. So running through the system, these are Canadian Solar 445 watt bifacial solar panels. Now these panels are perfect for them up here in North Idaho because it does snow, and the real advantage to a bifacial panel is that even if the front is completely covered in snow, the reflection off the snow can still hit the back of the panel. And essentially when solar panels are creating power from the sun, they create heat. So by allowing the sun to still reach the back of the panel, they create heat and can therefore melt the snow. Now these panels are mounted to a structure attached to a 20-foot shipping container, and this container is slightly recessed into the side of a hill. That way it has a little bit better thermal properties. And this rack is set up in such a way that it can be tilted for winter, so it can go up to 60 degrees in the wintertime, down to the optimal 35 degrees for summertime. That way they get the most power generation throughout the year. Now in total, there's 24 panels here. So there is strings of 8 going this direction, and there is a total of 3 strings. So that allows us to take advantage of a high voltage solar controller and really simplifies the wiring. So all 8 of these panels in series comes in just shy of 450 volts DC for the open circuit voltage in winter. And that allows us to take advantage of some of the leading edge charge controllers. So here we are inside. This is framed in with 2x3 studs, Artec insulation, and plastic wrap on the outside so that way no moisture can get in. It's sheeted with 7/16 OSB that is painted with a moisture inhibiting paint, and it just makes a perfect environment to put all this equipment up. Right now that solar power is coming in on these 10 gauge PV wires and is feeding into only one of the MPPT-RS solar controllers by Victron. And we're currently only using one because we didn't have available right now the battery cables to hook it up to our power distribution system. So right now all 24 panels are connected to one of these solar controllers. And the real advantage to these solar controllers is that 450 volt input, and they're a 100 amp output, which means each controller can handle about 5,500 watts of solar. That leaves them plenty of room for expansion because with their 3 strings right now, they're going to be using 2 strings on one controller, but only 1 on the second controller, so they have a 4th string available if they needed to add more solar panels in the future. From there, all that solar power comes in, and we need one of the best solutions for storing all of it. So we have here 12 of the SOK 48-volt 100 amp hour server rack packs. It gives them a total of just over 60 kilowatt hours, and they could discharge these, in theory, at a rate of 60 kilowatts. So no matter how crazy on the cheese whiz they get with their loads, they have the batteries that have the kick to run whatever they want. So with all that power, we need a way to manage that. And for that, we've turned to the Victron Lynx distribution system. So there's 3 components to it. The Lynx Power In, which is just some bus bars that allow us to combine all of our battery packs. The Lynx Shunt that monitors all of the batteries. And then the Lynx distributor that contains all the fuses going to the solar controllers and the inverters. Now you may be wondering why we have a Lynx Shunt here. Well, it's simple. It contains the main 500 amp DC fuse in there. The other thing is this system will be expanded to exceed the maximum of 15 batteries on one Servo GX. So this is going to allow them to monitor the state of charge no matter how big they grow their battery bank. In other words, it's leaving plenty of room for future expansion. And then on the business end, we have 2 of Victron's finest Quattro 10,000s. These things are massive. This gives them a total of 20,000 watts continuous output with a 2x surge, which means when they turn stuff on, they have up to 40,000 watts available at that instant. Now, these inverters are a low-frequency transformer-based topology, and those were selected because there's a CNC plasma table with the plasma unit, a big air compressor, and many other loads that have a big hit when they first turn on, and we wanted to make sure that there was enough momentum. Think of a transformer like a flywheel. We wanted to make sure there was enough momentum to have a big hit when those loads turn on. With these Quattro 10Ks, we have more than enough juice to do anything they could possibly want, and these can be expanded in the future to a much bigger system just by adding a couple more of them. Now, something to be mindful of is when you're using Victron inverters in parallel, things need to be equal. So you'll notice these battery cables here are equal length, and these are our pre-made cables here from Current Connected. These are a 4-foot length, 4-aught gauge, and they're hydraulically crimped with a 10,000 PSI hydraulic crimper. And then the AC output is just ran through some 1-inch seal tight with 2-gauge wire over to a load center, and this is just one readily available from Home Depot. And this is their main panel. From this panel, it'll feed to their shop and power whatever they possibly could plug into it. Riley and Courtney are awful like-minded, just like me, so that made it really easy to use the same saying, what would you do if it were your system? And it was a great pleasure to get to meet them, work with them, and install a system that I know is going to meet their needs for a long time to come.